Why use Telmisartan in bodybuilding? Welcome to J3 University, your source for physique enhancement education. Question I got was, why are people using Telmisartan in the enhanced physique competitor arena in bodybuilding? And in general, I wanted to just address, like, why are people using just ARBs in general, which Telmisartan is an ARB, which is an angiotensin-renin blocker. So it's blocking the actions of angiotensin 2. And so why would they use this within bodybuilding? And with usage of supra-physiological dosages of PEDs in general, more anabolic androgenic steroids and growth hormone, where a lot of the problems arise with using these compounds is that they do increase the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. And so this is released renin by the kidneys, which then goes to the liver and is converted to angiotensin 1. The lungs convert to angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 has some sites around the body that it works at for receptor sites. One being the kidney to cause it to hold more water, sodium, the adrenal glands to increase aldosterone output, which further increases sodium retention. Also for the pituitary gland to release antidiuretic hormone, which causes water reabsorption. So all this process is really important to regulate blood volume and blood pressure if it was to drop to low. But you could see that this could be problematic if you have an overactivation of this system. We're going to abbreviate and call it RAAS, so I'm not always saying renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. So if you have overactivation of the system is when a lot of issues can arise. For one, with higher levels of RAAS activity, you would guess it, you'd have greater water retention. This is a lot of times what you were seeing with taking high doses of anabolics is increase in water retention. A lot of times estrogen gets blamed, but it can be a lot due to this system. Then also with that water retention, you can have an increase in blood pressure. So yes, this system can healthily regulate blood pressure, but also it can really increase blood pressure as well. Now, along with just those regulations, this isn't just about blood pressure. Although blood pressure, it puts more pressure on for the heart and the kidneys and just the whole vascular system, but angiotensin 2 can also increase inflammatory factors. Interleukin 6, tumor necrosis factor. All these inflammatory cytokines can damage organ systems, damage the kidney. They go to the brain. Just think of them systemically, these inflammatory markers going around, moving around the organ systems and causing tissue damage and inflammation. This is why some of the leading issues with high dosages of PEDs are in the heart, the brain, and the kidney. Part of it is being in this pro-inflammatory state and is usually a root cause to a lot of disease states that we're seeing with insulin resistance, cardiovascular disease, Alzheimer's, dementia, the cognitive disorders, and chronic renal failure. So this is very, very important. It goes beyond just blood pressure regulation with the system. So you have this increase in inflammatory markers. Also, just steroid use in general can cause an increase in reactive oxygen species. So it causes more oxidative stress. And again, this is to the system as a whole. And oxidative stress can also impact organ function as well. So with this system, you're having an increase in reactive oxygen species, oxidative damage, inflammatory markers, and high blood pressure. And we see this overactivation of the RAAS system is very prevalent in cardiovascular disease, which causing tissue remodeling and left ventricular hypertrophy, cardiac dysfunction, endothelial cell dysfunction. So your blood vessels are also going to be stiffer and won't be able to relax as much. You can have a decrease in nitric oxide synthase too. So you're no longer having this elasticity within your blood vessels, causing damage to the arteries, and you have this inflammatory state now causing more atherosclerosis. And so it's just this whole cascade of snowball kind of occurs. So what do we do about it? Well, what do we address? You're taking high doses of PEDs. This is a major factor in all these issues that arise in this increase in RAAS. What do you do? Well, we have angiotensin 2 receptor blockers, an ARB. And we basically all the negative things I said, they work to reverse that. So we see a decrease in blood pressure, decrease in water retention. For one, is great just from a physique aspect, especially even during a contest peak week. I've used ARBs to lower angiotensin 2, and in turn lowers aldosterone and diuretic hormone, people can retain less water via that means. Rather than using a diuretic, we're addressing even further back the root issue here. So that aesthetic reason. Also, in off-season phases, if you're having a lot of water retention, sometimes you can blur the lines between, am I gaining body fat? Am I gaining, is this water? Is this muscle? So it helps to give a little bit of a clear picture of the type of progress you're making. But all the health benefits too. Lower inflammation, lower oxidative stress. All those are huge positives. And so that within turn, it also is going to be neuroprotective for the brain, cardiac protective, and renal protective. So it's going to protect the heart, the brain, and then the kidneys. And decrease, actually shown reversal even in some cases of atherosclerosis, cardiac remodeling, issue being left ventricular hypertrophy, right, in PED users. It's a protective thing against this. So all these RBs have this mechanism. There's telmisartan, valsartan, losartan. That's something of consideration of, you know, with your doctor, what might be something be in place. Telmisartan has been one that's been more popular, and I want to bring it up because it has been talked about so much. And there's a few reasons why so, and more so for PED users specifically. One reason being it has a very long half-life of roughly 24 hours. So once a day dosing can be used during that way. Also, it does work on the PPAR-Y pathway, which has gene expressions in regard to carbohydrate and lipid metabolism. So we're going to see positive alterations to increasing insulin sensitivity and also favorable for lipid changes. So it can lower LDL, raise HDL, which are very pertinent to users. And you can also have just a decrease in visceral body fat too, with regard to that increase in beta oxidation, fatty acid metabolism. So you have this kind of this extra benefit that telmisartan brings about, which we do see as in bodybuilding. What's happening? You know, insulin resistance is occurring. You have a partitioning towards visceral adipose tissue, and then you can have a compound where you have a 24-hour protective role versus some of the other ones with just shorter half-lives that might require more frequent dosing. So this is why we're seeing ARBs and more specifically telmisartan used in the enhanced competitor realm. And this is a prophylactic strategy. So it's not something to be utilized once you've gotten issues to arise. It's to be put in place to prevent issues from occurring long-term down the road. So it's something for consideration and something that would be utilized if you were to use it year-round, whether you're in a contest prep or even with an off-season setting. A couple questions that I had gone from it: if you had normal blood pressure, would it lower your blood pressure more? And no, this is if you had an overactivation of the RAAS system, you'd have a lowering of angiotensin II, blocking those receptors, and you'd have a normalization of blood pressure. If your blood pressure was already normal, it's not going to further lower it. And then also say, well, John, I don't have high blood pressure. Why would I even take this then? It's because even elevated aldosterone, independent of high blood pressure, so even if you had normal blood pressure, but you still had raises in aldosterone, still presents risk for cardiovascular disease and atherosclerosis, just independent just of blood pressure. Okay, so just keep that a note that yes, it works on blood pressure, but we have all these other benefits that it provides and protective aspects. So anyway, that's going to wrap up my question, which is a long-winded question, of course, with me answering this stuff as usual. If you have another question, you want me to answer it, leave it in the comments below, and I'd be happy to hit it on our next Q&A from J3U.